Hey everyone and welcome back to Daily Tuition. In this video, we will look at the roadmap of learning AI. Beginning the journey to understanding AI can be exciting. The pathway to educating ourselves about AI starts with a strong foundation in core concepts like mathematics and statistics, coupled with some programming languages. Central AI concepts are machine learning and deep learning, which can be seen in applications like image recognition and natural language processing. The journey is confirmed by getting hands dirty and staying relevant. So let's first understand where you can start learning AI. So first, you have to level up your math skill. AI relies on math. Grasping the basics of linear algebra, calculus, statistics, and probability will be your superpower. These concepts help you to understand how AI algorithms work and analyze data. After that, you need a programming skill. You have to master in Python. Python is your AI best friend. It is easy to code and has fantastic libraries such as NumPy and Pandas for learning AI applications. After that, you have to understand machine learning and deep learning. This is where the magic happens. Machine learning is the ability of machines to learn from data, similar to self-educating expert. These are different type of machine learning algorithm. You also need to learn deep learning. Deep learning is the most advanced AI technology and is based on the structure of a human brain. It employs the intricate layers of neural networks to deal with big data. It is a slightly more complex topic, but it is worth taking a look at if you are interested in the topic of AI. After that, you have to understand natural language processing. Natural language processing is like a special translator for a computer that is capable of understanding human language. It assists them to comprehend our everyday language, such as you and I speaking, as opposed to having to use special codes. Just after that, you need to take a closer look at supervised and unsupervised learning. Supervised learning is like having a super smart helper who has been trained by someone with a lot of knowledge. You give your helper pictures of cat and dog as data. You explain to them which are cat and which are dog. This is like teaching them the difference between black and white or between day and night. When they see a new picture, or you can say a new data, they are able to predict if it is a cat or dog or any other animal depending on what you have shown them before. But supervised learning is all about the use of clear examples to train a computer program for doing a particular task. As opposed, there is unsupervised learning. Let me explain unsupervised learning with a simple example. Think of sorting clothes. Unsupervised learning is like sorting a pile of laundry. Perhaps you could fold all the shirts and place them in a pile, and you do the same to the pants, even if they are not the same color. You make your own groups depending what you are able to observe. To sum up, the unsupervised learning is about discovering that things are similar or different in a huge pile of stuff, without being given instructions on how to sort them at first. After that, you can learn generative AI. Generative AI can be described as a super copycat machine, but it is much better than any copycat machine could ever be. For example, you can present it with a set of pictures, let's say a dog, as an input data. It learns what makes a dog look like a dog from all those pictures. It can then apply that knowledge, paint a whole new picture of a dog that you have ever seen before. It may be a silly dog with three legs or a dog wearing a hat, but it will still be interpreted as a dog based on what it has learned from the photos. Generative AI is roughly the same as a concept of giving a machine a set of objects and telling it to create a new object of a same kind. So here in the generative AI, you will learn a new concept called convolutional neural networks for image recognition. Convolutional neural networks are like super intelligent guessers for computers. They operate by breaking an image into tiny regions. As you look at the image as a series of squares, analyzing what is in the region and then combining the result to get the whole image. A common question people have is where the convolutional neural network work their magic. The convolutional neural network used in your phone, when you unlock your phone, or the exciting way of finding your friend in the picture. This concept is also in the self-driving cars. Recognizing the object like traffic signals and other walking on the road For that, we need the convolutional neural network. After that, we learn about computer vision. To understand computer vision, let's understand a very simple example. A robot that is sorting toys in a room full of toys scattered all over the place. The camera enables the robot to capture the toys, while the brain allows it to comprehend what they are. Then it can categorize them into groups. Computer vision makes a machine to use a camera to see and interpret the world slightly better than before, like a friend who assists in arranging toys. This technique is also use your face to unlock the phone by identifying the picture of you. This also assists the self-driving car to perceive the road and the object within it, such as traffic signal. As I conclude, remember that the AI is like a super helpful friend who remembers everything you tell them and uses that information to give you suggestions or answer your questions. I hope you understand this concept. There are many more to learn in AI. AI is a huge topic. So stay tuned with me. If you find anything useful, make sure to press the like button, share this video with your friends, subscribe for more latest videos. I will see you in the next one.